Today we'll be exploring the Indian Pueblo Culture Center and watching dances. But first, let's drive along Route 66 a little bit and explore downtown. This early morning, there are balloons flying, even though it's not time for the famous Albuquerque Balloon Festival. Let's watch.
Up, up and away. You can see so much from up here. This is a beautiful day and I know you will have a wonderful time watching the dances. We're not those Apache crown dancers something. People sure woke up when they came in. Now get a good night's sleep because it is time to turn eastward towards Amarillo tomorrow.
Now it's time to get our kicks on Route 66. Let's follow this through downtown. As we drive through the various neighborhoods, you'll notice the architecture is much different than here. A lot of adobe-style homes and flat roofs. I wonder how they keep them from leaking. And now we arrive at the Pueblo Indian Culture Center, where we'll be exploring Indian culture for the rest of the day. We'll be taking this route through the museum. We'll first look at the museum and its displays. Then we'll come outside and watch Indian dancing by various groups before going in and shopping at the gift store, eating at their cafe, and then leaving. Let's get started. As we said before, there are 19 pueblos in New Mexico, and we were at the Santa Clara yesterday. Early pueblos on flat land were basically just mud huts. Later, they started to improve on them by making them multi-story and using ladders to climb between the various levels. Then came more elaborate dwellings like this Zuni Pueblo model here. And they were all made out of mud bricks or tufa bricks, which they would then smooth out to use for their construction. And then we move into more modern type pueblos here. As we see in this model of the Tiuni Pueblo, they had ladders on the outside but could be pulled up for defensive purposes and you climbed in through the ceiling. They also had kivas, which were public buildings that they would gather in for special services. After they moved out of the cliffs, many of the pueblos centered around a Catholic mission church. Many still follow a religion that is kind of a synthesis between Catholicism and the native religions, worshiping many of the saints. The fireplace would be the heart and soul of the people, and that's where they gathered often. The Pueblo Indians have always been people who love art and have always done drawings and petroglyphs. Each one of the pueblos developed its own forms of art and pottery. music, and dance. They did many different types of beautiful weaving, and they used vertical looms to do them with. As said before, each one of the Pueblos had their own culture that they developed, and you could tell where somebody was from by their clothes, by their pottery, even by their language. And today, even the modern Pueblos are still somewhat like the old ones. The Pueblo Indian Culture Center has been designed to look somewhat like a Pueblo, with ladders and with the way the roof beams come out to provide shelter and shade. And its walls are enhanced by various types of Pueblo art. There's an arts and craft fair going on, but we have come for something else. We're here to watch the native dancing. Various groups dance here on a regular basis to show off their culture of the various native groups in the United States. Today we'll be seeing three groups. First, the Yellowbird Apache Dancers, and then the Zuni Ola Maidens, and in the end, the Tony Apache Crown Dancers. Thank you. Next, we'll be watching the Apache Crown Dancers. The crosses are not Christian symbols, but signify the four directions of the spirits. And this is a healing service.
Oh,
We'll be eating at the Pueblo Harvest Cafe some traditional Native American foods, among them onion rings fried in blue cornmeal. And then it's time to dance our way into the night for the end of another day.